It's the biggest mental health organisation in the country, and tonight Mental Health Australia is without a leader. Its chair, Matt Berriman, quitting in disgust over what he calls inaction on the nation's mental health crisis.
In the wake of the attack at Westfield Bondi Junction and the Sydney church stabbing, the state of the nation's mental health system is in the spotlight. Both the Bondi attacker and West Sydney teen with histories of mental illness.
I think it's a no-brainer. The country would be stronger, it'd be safer, we'd be much less likely to have tragedies like Bondi happening if there was a proper mental health system in place.
The government's commitment to mental health coming into question again.
We can always do better when it comes to mental health.
And again.
We provided some $586 million for mental health and suicide prevention in our last budget.
And again.
There is obviously the more that we should be doing in this country, and I'm sure we'll have more to say about that over the next little while as well.
Every year, one in five experiences a mental health condition. Almost half of all Australians will battle with poor mental health in their lifetime.
We're spending $12 billion a year on mental health for the whole of Australia, and we're spending $42 billion on the NDIS, which is for, you know, about a tenth of the number of people. So you've got to have equity here.
Now, just 2 weeks before the federal budget, Matt Berriman, the chair of Mental Health Australia, has quit, citing a lack of traction from the government amid a national crisis.
Matt's a bit of a lightning rod for what ordinary Australians are feeling following Bondi. Underneath the surface, there's a fair bit of anger and frustration in the community, and also a bit of fear. To dismiss him as just someone who just spat the dummy would be a big mistake.
And Matt Berriman is with us now. Matt, you've said today that the reason you resigned is because you couldn't say what you want to say. Here's your chance. What do you want to say?
Yeah, thank you, and thanks for having me on. As Chair of Mental Health Australia, I took that as a massive privilege, and I spent nearly 3 years in that role. And it's really important in that role to be bipartisan, and you can only affect real change advocacy-wise in that kind of position. Bipartisan work you have to do on all sides. But it got to a point where I actually didn't have a bipartisan view, and therefore I didn't feel like I would be able to discharge my duties in the way I wanted to. And therefore, I felt no other option other than to resign.
What was your view then?
My view is the Labor government hasn't committed to mental health.
And why do you think that is? Why is your... You seem to be targeting Anthony Albanese. Why is that?
I think because it starts at the top. Leadership starts at the very top. And we've always said it's an all-government approach. It's not just a health portfolio approach. Like, today is a great example. Our servicemen and women, defence has got some horrible statistics of people that have come home, suicide, PTSD. So it should be in the defence budget, should be in the housing budget, it should be in education, in our schools. So to have an all-government approach, the Prime Minister has to stand up and be part of that.
Those soldiers can't even find psychiatrists. They can't get appointments.
Exactly.
When they come back, after fighting for us in places like Afghanistan. That's disgraceful.
And a lot of people can't get the help they need. And I've run people like the CAT team, the crisis assessment team, to go and check on someone as a welfare check because they've threatened imminent threat to life. And basically they're saying we can't take them into the public hospital and or we don't know whether it's serious, it might blow over type of stuff. So I think the government now, if they don't start now, when will they?
You won't want to hear this then. We asked the Prime Minister's office for a statement. He said the reform needed is complex, won't happen overnight. And he then says, look, we established the Mental Health Reform Advisory Committee, which your organisation is part of, to shape its response.
Yeah, and that's great that, well, A, that he's responded, that's good. But secondly, there's been Productivity Commission, Royal Commission in Mental Health in Victoria. How many more commissions, how many more things? It's just kicking the can down the road.
Have you actually spoken to the Prime Minister?
No, never met or spoke.
Over the course of your entire tenure?
Yeah.
Why is that?
Probably another question for him.
So you've tried?
Absolutely, yeah, and multiple people have tried on my behalf that are close to him.
We've heard the PM say that $500 million was spent on mental health funding last budget. Is there an argument that the Prime Minister and the government have a lot of things they've got to spread money around for and mental health is just a part of that?
There's obviously a lot of challenges and issues around financial and fiscal management, but I also think when you look at some of the statistics around what it does in productivity, mental health is costing this country $70 billion a year in lost productivity.
It's extraordinary. Wow.
So, and the Productivity Commission said with a full reform package that could be reduced significantly. So there is actual financial and fiscal, not only health, reasons to do this. And that's from a business background. I look at it and say $1.2 billion a year to make 68 and a half, it's probably not a bad trade.
Yeah. Matt, I feel like at least in my world, like being a member of the community and the media, all we do now is talk about mental health. And I feel like there was this real kind of objective to raise awareness to talk about mental health. And I feel like we talk about it so much, we've raised awareness, like we've done our bit. It's now on government maybe to meet us and start pulling their end of the bargain, so to speak. What needs to happen from here?
Yeah, and I think it's a multifaceted approach. So I think it's upon private as well. It's not just the government.
Yeah.
But the government's got to lead. Mm. And the people who are paying the taxes want it to go to the right areas. And that's where I talk about asset allocation. Where are we spending that money in the pie of the budget? And what's most important? And I think at the moment the question is mental health important enough? And obviously the answer is no from the current government.
There's a lot to do, Matt. We really thank you for your time. And if you do find yourself in need of help, crisis support is available 24/7 through Lifeline on 13 11 14.